a Queen of the Seas held court in Southampton water. The Queen Elizabeth prepares for sea. To share the thrill of her maiden voyage, we invite you aboard, where our reporter introduces Skipper Sir James Bisset.
It must be a great day for you, Commodore.
Oh, yes, yes. The flags are fluttering in the breeze and the passengers are coming on board and everybody looks very happy and we're all looking forward to a good voyage.
I see. Well, passengers would like to wish you a very warm bon voyage, sir.
Thank you very much indeed. Goodbye.
Goodbye, sir.
Good luck to you.
And now for the crew's youngest member.
You're Billy Bath, are you?
Yes, sir.
You're the youngest member of the crew?
Yes.
It's your first trip to sea?
Yes, sir.
How do you feel about it?
Well, seems all right so far.
Now, buttonholing Miss Frances Day.
Hello, Frances. How are you?
Hello, John. How are you?
Doctor?
You know the doctor, don't you?
How do you do?
How do you feel about the trip?
Oh, absolutely thrilled beyond all words.
You'll bring back a lot of nylons?
Oh, no, I don't think I'll bring back any nylons. I think I'll just stick to bringing back some food. That's a much better idea.
Here's Nuffield car king, Sir Miles Thomas.
Even the most hardened traveller gets a thrill out of the first civilian departure of this great liner on her first civilian voyage. It's forging a link between the English-speaking peoples of the Western Hemisphere on so much of the peace and prosperity of the world depends.
Ambrose and singer Evelyn Dall.
Oh, splendid. I'm looking forward to it. Haven't been to America for 8 years. I'm very anxious to get over there.
Well, Miss Dall, you're quite excited too, I expect.
Oh, I'm thrilled to bits. Can't wait till we get going.
Good. I wish you a very happy trip.
Thank you very much.
I'm sure we will have one. It looks wonderful, doesn't it?
Good.
And Nuremberg's Norman Birkett.
Well, I'm looking forward to it very much indeed. I feel rather like a schoolboy this morning on the Queen Elizabeth's first trip, but hope very much to have a rest in the United States of America and to fulfill one or two public duties.
Last arrival, Vyacheslav Molotov with a bag full of mystery. Aboard her on this voyage, 2,300 travellers. With 50 of them aboard, even millionaires are to a penny. And there she goes, the world's most beautiful ship.